brought me here to see you. You look troubled. What's on your mind?
My heart is heavy. My own sister raised a noble woman by my father and mother has broken the moral code of how a young woman should behave. As you know, she went missing from the kingdom after she heard the proposal of Junggong Mardeo. I understand that she did not want to marry him, but when I went to the kingdom of Namardo, I saw her in the garden, alone with Arjuno. His left hand was on her left hand. His right hand was on her right hand, as he stood behind her and showed her how to shoot an arrow. I was shocked. That is not proper behavior for a young princess. I have called you here to discuss the matter. You are harsh on your sister. As a married woman, you have forgotten what it is like to be young. Moreover, Srikandhi is different from you. Not only is she young, but she is desperate to learn archery. As you know, she is destined to be a woman warrior and to take part in the Proto-Yudo War. The person who is at fault is Arjuno. He is older than her and her teacher. Arjuno should have insisted that there was a chaperone present while he taught her. Were the two in public sight? Has there been rumors going around?
No. I think I was the only person who saw.
Well, how did you see?
I peeked through the bushes and saw them.
Ah, if you hadn't have spied on them, you wouldn't be in that dilemma now. No one would know but the two young people concerned. But all is not lost, Tripathi. If the two young people are keen, they could marry. Why don't you ask Srikandhi if she is interested, and I will ask Arjuna.
Prabhu Kresno, I think your counsel is wise. Come and eat with us now, then you can decide who to send with a message for Arjuna.
I've got big problems at the moment and my mind isn't particularly great.
Oh, what is it, my dear?
Well, I've got an exam tomorrow. And a loner made me come along to a performance when I wanted to study.
Oh, well, that's not too bad, is it?
Well, I asked her if I could go home straight after I performed, and she said no, that was impolite. I had to sit and wait for the rest of it.
Well, That's good. You learn manners at university. I like that. Anyway, I can tell you something about studying, Dawn.
What's that, Jung?
If you work hard right through the year, there is no need to study the night before.
Is that true, Jung?
Yes, it's true. What you need to do is have a warm bath, watch a little bit of trashy television, take it easy, and then go early to bed.
But I never get to sleep when I go to bed before an exam. Anyway, the biggest problem is I haven't done any study all year.
Well, that's your problem then, isn't it? This is a big lesson of life, and maybe you need to learn it.
I think I have learned it already.
You haven't learned it well enough because you didn't do your study before you came to the Gamelan performance.
Well, I just hope they won't talk for too long in this show because I really need to get home.
Okay, Duke. Usually I like to chatter on, but I'm concerned about your exam. So we'll pop off now and then you can study once we finish the performance.
Thank you, thank you.
But there's one thing we have to do first.
What's that, Jung?
A good student thanks their lecturers. So I think you should thank your lecturer. And not only that, but we have another thank you tonight, which is to Professor Cathy Falk, or we wouldn't be here.
Wouldn't we be here without her?
No, the room wouldn't be here, the Gamelan wouldn't be here.
But we could just sit up on our own and do a show? Nah.
Nothing without the musical accompaniment. And Ed, without the screen, without everything. It's the whole atmosphere.
Okay, I understand now.
So I think that we need to thank Professor Cathy Falk for setting up Gamelan.
At all now, can I go and study?
No, you have to wait until the end of performance, or do you know what will happen to you?
No, I don't know.
Ilona will go in to the marks and she'll say, I saw you sneaking out 5 minutes early. Fail.
Really?
Really? She told me herself.
Well, I better stay to the end of the performance.
And then help clean up and then go home and have a good night's sleep. You'll do just fine in your exam. I have confidence in you.
I don't have confidence.
It doesn't matter. Your old mum has confidence in you and you will achieve great things.
You say so.
I say so. But next year, I think, start studying before the night before.
Okay, I will next year.
In the meantime, Kresno has called for Trusto Jumano, Drupadi's and Srikandhi's brother. Kresno gives Trusto Jumano a message for Arjuna, asking him to come to the kingdom of Dwarawati, as Kresno wishes to discuss an important matter with him. Trusto Jumano calls the soldiers and gets ready to leave the kingdom. The troops depart like a pouncing lion.
Thank you.
sister, Drupadi. She says that you behaved inappropriately when teaching archery to Srikandhi. What have you to say to yourself?
No, you are like an older brother to me. As about your question about my behavior, I was teaching Srikandhi archery.
But without a chaperone, I hear. When your concubine, Larasati, is a skilled archer herself, and she could have accompanied you. Indeed, she could have taught Srikandhi herself. Do you agree? Yes, you don't, do you? You can't say anything. Don't worry. I have a solution. If you love Srikandhi, and she is fond of you, would you like to marry her?
Yes.
But I'm not sure if Srikandhi would be willing. She killed Prabhu Jugumar's girl when he proposed to her. You behave badly, but not as badly as Prabhu Jugumar's girl. Drupadi will ask Srikandhi if she is willing. Let us go off to Pancholo and ask Srikandhi's father, Prabhu Jugumar, for her hand. If she is willing, then you need to ask your wife, Sambodra, and your concubine, Larasati, if they would accept Srikandhi as a co-wife. Law number one of 1974 on marriage states that co-wives must accept a second marriage.
I will always obey the law, so I will follow what you tell me to do.
Srikandhi has a mind of her own. It is best we call her. Trusto Jumino, can you fetch her?
Yes, Father. I will fetch her.
Thank you.
Srikandhi. Arjuna is asking for your hand in marriage. Will you accept?
Yes, I will. On one condition. Arjuna must organize... Don't be in the face. Arjuna must organize an archery contest between myself and another woman who is able to defeat me.
Srikandhi, you are an excellent archer, but I think I know of the right woman. Someone who has learned archery with me for longer than you. I will discuss the issue with her and organize the contest. I will let you know when it is ready.
Thank you.
happy to marry me now, now that you have been defeated by my concubine, Larasati.
Arjuna, I will be happy to join your household and to become a sister to Sumbhadra and Larasati, if they are happy.
I had intended to ask them, but I got distracted organizing the archery contest. Sorry, could you step aside for a minute?
Yes, of course.
Sumbhadra and Larasati, I have something I wish to discuss with you. It is a delicate matter.
Speak your mind, Arjuna. What is it that's troubling you?
It's a bit difficult to discuss. Well, as I said, it's a delicate issue. You know I taught Srikandhi archery.
I have just taken part in an archery contest with her, so of course I know that.
Well, feelings arose in the course of the classes, and I would like to marry her. But as you are aware, law number one of 1974 on marriage requires the permission of co-wives to a new wife. Do you give your permission?
You are away often on quests, and sometimes we get very lonely. Srikandhi can keep us company in your absence. Srikandhi is strong and brave and good fun to be with. We would be happy for her to join the household. Srikandhi, my sister, don't stand back. Come here. Srikandhi, we welcome you. I will teach you all I know about archery, and you will become the best woman archer in the kingdom.